the Craigslist killer who arrived at the Holiday Inn Express.
Our video surveillance captured him entering the lobby area, passing the desk. He heads down towards the west stairwell. We also see him at that point removing the baseball cap that he had on.
Just before 11, he knocked at room 348.
She answered the door and saw what she described to me as a younger-looking, early 20s, professional-looking male.
He seemed harmless enough, so the stripper let him into her room. But once again, as in the Boston cases, he pulled a gun. The stripper knew right away who she was dealing with.
She screamed. The suspect at that time told her to shut up. Then he told her, I'm not going to hurt you. I'm just looking for money or credit cards. He then bound her hands behind her back with plastic flex cuffs.
Then the Craigslist killer searched the room for valuables. As he lined his pockets, he asked where her laptop was, and she said she didn't have one.
He then told her, if I find a computer in the room, I'll kill you. And she said at this point she was terrified for her life.
But the woman was lucky. She was traveling with her husband, and he was waiting in the lobby for her to check in.
Because she had not contacted her husband in the lobby, her husband came up to the room, and he had the key to the room. So he opened the door.
He was confronted by this individual who was pointing a gun at him. He observed his wife on the floor, bound behind him. He immediately stepped out of the room. He said at that point, the suspect followed him into the hall. When he heard the door shut, the husband turned around and ran down the hallway.
The robber fled in the other direction, down a stairway and out a back door. Meanwhile, the woman, who's never spoken publicly, called hotel security. She had no doubt who had attacked her.
When she responded down to the lobby, she was yelling that it's the same thing as Boston, the same thing as Boston.
There were indeed many similarities to the crimes. The man answered an ad posted on Craigslist. He pulled a gun and used zip ties to bind the woman, just as he had in the Boston cases. And once again, surveillance cameras caught him in the lobby of the Holiday Inn. Police in Rhode Island and Boston were convinced it was the same man.
The fact that he committed a very similar crime only days after the homicide of Julissa Brisman, we found just extraordinary.
To continue the same type of behavior right away is kind of like a runaway train. It's very fortunate in a way.